Good evening, everyone. How you all doing on this blessed and wonderful evening on tonight? Amen. Pray that you all are blessed on tonight as we share what God has for us to share with you on tonight. Amen. I thank God for being God, for He is good and He is good all of the time. Amen. And truly, truly, He deserves all of the praise. Amen. Tonight, I can't see your comments on tonight for some reason, but I'm going to go ahead and I'll share what God has for me to share. Amen. And so I'm praying that you all can hear me, and I pray that you all are truly and richly blessed on tonight. Amen. Amen. Tonight, amen, we are going to begin a series of lessons, what I call top priority. And so I pray that it blesses you in some way. I thank God, amen. I thank God for using me, amen. And I thank God for you all, amen. And I pray that you all are blessed on tonight, amen. I'm praying that you all have begun a good new year, and that we know everything is not going to always go our way, but we do know that God is in control, and that God works things out according to His word, His will, and His way. So I just pray to God that you are blessed on tonight. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. We're going to do a song on tonight. Amen. And I pray it blesses you in some kind of way. Amen. And I pray that, you know, that you'll be able to kind of reminisce on maybe, you know, them olden times. Amen. It's one, amen, that I heard growing up in St. Mary. Amen. Praise the Lord. And it's one that is dear, very dear to my heart. Amen. And so we're going to share, amen, what God has for us to share on this blessed and wonderful evening. Go ahead, Chris.
My rock, my rock.
hallelujah. I love to praise his name. I said hallelujah, hallelujah. I love to praise his name. I love to praise his name, yeah. I love to praise his name. Amen. Again, amen. Truly God is good. Amen. And he is good all of the time. Amen. I thank God. Amen. For you all on tonight. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. And I wish I could see your comments. Amen. At this time. Amen. But I just pray to God that everything, the live is okay, and that you can hear everything and that everything is going well. Amen. That's my prayer. Amen. And I pray that it's going well. Amen. 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 So I think I see it here. So I think everything is going good. So we're just going to go ahead and share what God has placed upon our heart to share. On tonight, we're going to begin a series of lessons dealing with top priority. And see, going into the new year, many a times, you know, we have New Year's resolutions and, you know, things we just want to do better with, and things we want to be better at, and we just want to be better as people. And so I just thought it fitting to share this lesson with us in a series, amen, of lessons as it relates to those things that are top priority. Now, we're going to get into the lesson, and I pray that it gives you some kind of perspective. Amen. We're going to use this scripture as a scripture that we're going to kind of spin off of, and we'll be sharing other scriptures as well. And so we're going to go ahead and share that. And I want to share this with you. Your Bible, amen, the pages ought to be kind of rattled a little bit, amen, because you're using it, amen. So if you have a Bible, amen, we're going to be flipping on tonight, amen, just as long as we don't, what, flip out of the Bible, amen, praise the Lord. And so we thank God on tonight. Tonight our scripture will come from Matthew chapter 6, verse number 33, Matthew chapter 6. Verse number 33. Amen. The word of God, it says this. It says, but seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added to you. Amen. I'll read it again. But seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added to you. Amen. The grass withered, the flower thereof fadeth away, but the word of our God shall stand forever. Let us pray on tonight. Dear God and Father, we say thank you. We thank you for being so kind, and we thank you for being so merciful, dear God. I pray right now, Lord, that you would just have your way, Father God. Do whatever it is, Lord, that you want to do through me, Lord, and use me, dear God, to bless these your people. I pray right now, dear God, that you would just allow this vessel, dear God, to share only what it is that you want shared on tonight. Open up the hearts of your people and allow them, dear God, to receive what you have for them. We thank you, we love you, and Lord, we do praise you. It's in Jesus' mighty name we do pray. And all of God's children said, amen, amen, amen. Truly God is good, amen. And he is good all of the time. Amen. And so we thank him for all his many blessings that he's bestowed upon us. Amen. And we thank him for being so kind and so good. Tonight, amen, we're going to take a look at priorities. Amen. And not just priorities, but we're going to try to figure out what should be our top priorities. And so what we're going to do, we just want to share some things as it relates to priorities so we can kind of get an idea of what it is. Now, many of us can say that, oh, this is important to me, That's important to me. The other is important to me. But one thing we all have to remember is this one thing. Whatever is important to you, amen, you are going to actually implement it in your life, right? And so when we begin to say God is important to me, or this is important to me, or, you know, reading God's word is important to me, doing God's will is important to me, really, when we look at it, we can say it, amen, but we've got to make sure we understand that it's not just something we merely just say, right? Our priorities, what is important to us, it's going to show up in our day-to-day. And so it is my prayer that we reveal and share some things with you on today. Just want you to kind of get this idea of priorities. When we take a look at priorities, I want you to kind of get that whole idea of first or above all, or first on the list. And so in the Word of God, there's scriptures in the Bible that really tell us what some of our priorities, what ought to be, right? And so there's some key words that you can look at in the Word of God that will literally tell you what's important to God, or what should be important to you, because it is what important to God. So one key word, when you see it in the Word of God, it ought to just put something on your mind, right? The word nevertheless, right? So when you look at that whole word nevertheless, it's never what? Never should be put at the bottom, right? It should be put up at the top. So when you see that word, what? Nevertheless, right? It ought to spark something in you. Look what it says in Ephesians 5 and 33. Now, these are just scriptures where the word shows up, and I just want to show you where our lives should be adjusted based on what God has said, right? So when we take a look at the scripture, right, where, you know, the husband is to do what he's supposed to do for his wife, look what he says. It says, nevertheless, let each one of you in particular so love his wife as himself, and let the wife see that what? She respects her husband. So when you take a look right here, what happens is you might have had a segment of scripture, right, that has been given. But then at the end, it'll say what? Nevertheless, right? And you know, the preacher would say something like this. If you didn't get anything else, right, you need to get this, right? And so when you see that word nevertheless, that's really what it's saying, right? This is very important, right? So it says, nevertheless, each one of you in particular so should love his own wife as himself, right? So as a husband should really love his wife as himself, right? So he shouldn't dog her out. He shouldn't treat her bad, right? So his main objective is really to treat her, right, like she's worth something, right? And also it says, let the wife see that she respects her husband, right? So you got to understand this one thing. That's very important for the wife to what? Respect her husband. Now, she's to do other things, but when you see that word nevertheless, can I help you? As a wife, that should be on your top, on your list, what? Respecting your husband. So I'm just kind of pointing out some things in the scripture to where really and truthfully, we've got to pay attention, right, to that word nevertheless. Look what it says. In Luke 22 and 42, it says what? Saying, Father, if it is your will, take this cup away from me. But look what it says. Nevertheless, not my will, but yours be done. So you've got to understand, Christ is at a point in his ministry where what? He's about to be tormented, right? He's about to be killed. He's about to be slaughtered for what? The sins of mankind. And what he's saying is, he's saying, Lord, what I want is really for you to take this away from me. But he said, what's really important, he says, nevertheless, not my will, but yours be done. So we've got to understand, when we take a look at that whole idea of nevertheless here, really God's will should be of top priority, right? So we've got to understand. I'm saying, seek ye first what? The kingdom of God, right? So look in Proverbs chapter 19, verse 21. Right? It says, there are plans in a man's heart. But look what it says. Nevertheless, the Lord's counsel will stand. So you got to understand that, guess what? There's some plans we have in our hearts, some things we want to do, but what God wants, his counsel, his will, what it's going to actually stand. So what God wants is really, it should be of top priority to us, right? And so in other words, you might see in the word of God is what above all, right? Above all, right? And so when you look at that above all, it could mean number one, or it can mean what it should be very, what, important to you. And of course, this is a given. The Bible says in Psalms 135:5, for I know that the Lord is great and our Lord is above all gods, right? So God is at the top of the list, right? There's no God like our God, right? God is who he is. He's set apart. He is holy. He's above all. He can't be put in the category with anybody or what? Anything else. So God should be of what? Top priority. The God of heaven, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the God who created the heavens and the earth, the God who created you and me, the God who sent what, his only begotten Son, that whosoever should believe it in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Amen. So God should be what? Important, because he's above all, right? Look what it says in 1 Peter 4:8. It says, and above all things, right? So there was a segment of scripture where the people, God's people, shared some things with God's people. And now it says, above all things, have fervent love one for one another, and love will cover a multitude of sin. So as Christians, what? Love should be at the top, what? Of our list. And it says, what? A fervent love for one another. Amen. Look at Colossians 3:14. It says, but above all these things, put on love, which is the bond of perfection or maturity. So we've got to understand that we know in the Bible it says above all, love, right? Love. So we've got to understand that there's some priorities that we ought to have and set for ourselves. In Proverbs 3:9, it says this, honor the Lord with your possessions and with the first fruits of your increase, right? This is kind of referring to the tithe. This is referring to not giving God what you got left, amen, but what? Giving him off the top, amen, right? Giving him off the top. And so when we take a look at that whole idea of what priorities, they are the things that are important. These are the things that should be above all else. These are the things that we ought to put what? At the top of our list. And we can all agree that somewhere within our lives, and even maybe now, our priorities have been mixed up, messed up, and not straight, right? And I just believe that many a times, people's lives aren't as fruitful as they can be, only because their priorities are not in place. The things that are important to them, right, sometimes are the things that actually what hurt them, as opposed to what helps them. So we've got to make sure that we what prioritize our lives and make sure we put the things on the top of the list that should be at the top, and the things that are on the bottom of the list be what at the bottom, right? And so here's a list of things, amen, that I just want to share with us. And tonight it's just going to serve as an introduction, right? And so we'll get deeper into the lesson, right? And tonight is going to serve as an introduction, just to get our minds wrapped around that whole idea of first or priority or what's important to us, right? So the scripture that I read, it says, seek ye what? First, right? The kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you, right? And so you got to understand, when you look at that scripture, really, it's the idea of first, and it's the idea of understanding if you put God first, then the things that you may be worrying about, the things that you may be stressing about, the things that you may, your mind may be boggled about, right? It says that all these things shall be added unto you. What is it talking about? What are you going to eat? What are you going to drink? What are you going to wear? What? The necessities of life. Now, notice, I didn't say your wants. I said the necessities of life, right? And so we've got to understand that when we prioritize God and his kingdom and righteousness, God says this, it's a promise. He says, I'll take care of you, right? All the things you're worrying about will be added unto you. Just do God's will. Seek after God. Seek his kingdom, and God will take care of the things that you need. Amen. Praise the Lord. He said, look at the birds. Amen. Look at the lilies of the field, right? They know they'll be provided for. Amen. Amen. So let's take a look. Now, I created a list of priorities that people may have. And listen, you may fall, one of these may be a priority of yours, and maybe it might be a priority that may not should be a priority. But at the same time, I just want to put some things on our mind just to see, right, to get us to reflect, to see where we are, right? Because we got to always kind of see where we are so we can make the right adjustments, right? So when you take a look at priorities, some individuals prioritize what? Their career, right? They try to work their way up the ladder. They try to what? Get here and make moves, what? To try to come up, what? In the company, in the business, or if they have what? Their own business. To many people, what? Their career is their priority. Some people it's family, right? So family what is vital and important to them, and it means what so much to them. And we gotta be honest, what family is more important to some people than it is to other people, right? But we can honestly say that it's a valid priority. Some people value what? Education. Right? Some people are lifelong learners. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Pastor just got him a degree. Amen. I'm 42 years old. Amen. So education may be a top priority of yours. Right? Financial stability. Right? Wanting to make sure that you got your ducks in a row. When it's time to retire, you have what you need. Or you managing, you know, your money so that you have what you need. Or you want to try to get the right job so you can live at a certain level. Right? So financial stability or security might be yours. Right? And then what I found is this. Now, there are times when some people's priority, right, is other people's career, ministry, family, or financial stability. Because sometimes, let's just be real, there are individuals who spend more time worrying about what other people are doing or not doing to where they really are shortchanging themselves. Right? And so when we look at this one, we've got to understand it's really, really minding your own business. You know what I realized is this one thing. Sometimes, hear me and hear me well, I pray this blesses you. Sometimes people are not where they could be in life only because they spend too much time looking at what other people are doing and really comparing and competing with other people, right? And so now they begin to try to be what that person is, or try to compete with that person, or try to feel like they want to get on that level, right? And so you got to understand that's dangerous, because you got to set your own priorities. Right? We're all different. We all have different strengths, different weaknesses, different ministries, different gifts. So we've got to understand that, guess what? That our priorities ought to be based on who God made us to be and what he's put us here to do. Some people's priority is what? Helping other people. Right? Some people's priority, whether some people agree with this or not, some people's priority is what other people think of them. Right? That's more important to some people than some of the other things that I've listed, right? And can I help somebody on tonight? You've got to understand that when you're so focused on what other people think, really, you just canceled out God as to what he thinks of you and what he wants of you, right? Some people, it's their health, right? It's top priority in their lives, right? For some people, it's pleasure, right? I'm going to enjoy life. I'm going to enjoy myself. I work hard, so I'm going to enjoy, right? Pleasure, right? Now, can I say that pleasure is a bad priority? No, but I can say that when you take a look at trying to do the things that you desire and that you want and trying to just fulfill the desires of the heart, what ends up happening is you get so caught up in what? Wanting to be what? Please and all this other stuff, to where really and truthfully you forget the fact that there's some time when God got some growing for you to do so that you can get to where he wants you to get. For some people, their priority is themselves, right? For some, it's being on time, right? And so that whole idea of just being on time, being on time, being on time. But what I've discovered in being on time, right, that is a top priority. But you know, the sad thing about that, I've seen so many people, right? They're on time for work every day, but their family's struggling, right? And so it amazes me how that is so important to some people, to where they would rather, amen, be on time for work than to actually make sure their family is straight, right? And so some of us and all of us has probably been guilty of that from time to time. But that's a valid priority, but you got to make sure you put it in what? Perspective, right? And so when we take a look at it, we ought to have priorities as Christians, right? We ought to prioritize what's true. We ought to prioritize growing in the Lord. We ought to prioritize witnessing what? The gospel of Jesus Christ. We ought to prioritize what? Serving in ministry. Now, preacher, why did you put these at the bottom? You know why? Because in many cases, the three that I named, right? The three that I named at the bottom, right? In many cases, and in many of our lives, that's where they are, right? All the other things are at the top: the career, the family, education, financial stability. You know what others think of us, our health, pleasure, all these other things are more important to us than what? Growing in the Lord, witnessing the gospel, serving in ministry. Can I help you? Those last three really should be what? At the top of our list. Why, preacher? The Bible says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. So that lets me know that serving him, witnessing the gospel of Jesus Christ, growing in the Lord should be what? Top priority. It should be first. It should be way what? Way at the top, right? And so I just pray to God that I've kind of gotten you to kind of analyze some things and look at some things and really begin to look at your priorities and what's really important to you. Now watch, all of the things, many of the things that I've listed, some of them may not be important really, really at all, but I threw them in there just to kind of get us to think about it. But really, a huge portion of these things are really priority. They are top priority. But here's our challenge. Our challenge is not to give anything too much attention to where we put it on a level, what? That it should not be. Amen. Praise the Lord. So we've got to understand that. We've got to get that. We've got to get that in our spirit. So watch. Check it out. So the Bible says this. It says, seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, right? And all these things shall be added unto you. The things you need, the things that you're worrying about, the things that you need provided to you. Watch me. It says, seek ye first. When you look at the idea of first, it just means chief or first rank or first place, right? And so I'm going to share this with you. And I don't think I'm going to get much further because I don't want to keep you long tonight. I didn't want to keep us long tonight, right? So watch. When you take a look at that whole idea of first, it says, seek first the kingdom of God. Now I'm going to stop right there, right? The kingdom of God, right, and his righteousness. Now here's the thing. Many people do, right? Many people who claim and call themselves Christians. And many times we as Christians, right, we'll say one thing, but really what we do, how we do it, the actions that we take really prove what kingdom we are serving, or it really proves that maybe we are not what? Seeking the kingdom of God. Okay, wait a minute, preacher. Help me out with this. I'm going to help you. You see, it says, seek ye first the kingdom, watch, of God. Right? And so what we've got to understand is this one thing. I share this with us all the time. We are in God's world. God is not in our world. Right? I'll say it again. We are in God's world. God is not in our world. And so when we understand that, we will understand that God is what? In control. He's in charge, right? He's got the whole world in his hands, and God got this. Amen. I don't care who trying to stay in the White House. Amen. I had to throw that in there. I don't care who's trying to win the Senate seat. I don't care who's in office, right? I don't care who feel they are in charge or in control. Can I help you? The kingdom of God. God is in charge. God is in control, right? And so what we've got to understand is this one thing, that we have to acknowledge God's sovereignty. Wait a minute, preacher, what do you mean? We have to acknowledge God's sovereignty. What does that mean? God is king. Amen. God is king. Now, hear me. I know we call each other kings and queens. You know, that's fine, because what we're doing is we're encouraging each other, right? Because we, you know, some of us have been beat down for so long throughout our lives to where we really need. Sometimes we got to encourage ourselves. Amen. You know, but at the same time, we've got to realize and remember and understand that God is king. Amen. Praise the Lord. So that means that, guess what? He's the one in charge. He's the one in control, right? Even the devil in hell can't do nothing, amen, without God's permission. So you got to get that, right? Go ask Job, amen, right? The devil had to get permission, amen, to mess with Job, amen, praise the Lord. So you got to understand that God is in full control. I don't care what the world looks like. I don't care what people say. I don't care what people do. God is in full control. So when you seek his kingdom, you understand that a kingdom has a king. Well, who's the king of God's kingdom? It's God, right? It's God, the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the creator of all, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the God who sent Christ to die for the sins of the world, right? He is in control. But not only that, what we've got to do is this. Sometimes, and some of us have said this before, I'm my own man, I'm my own woman. No, well, if you call yourself a child of God, I hate to bust your bubble, but guess what? You are no longer your own man, and you are no longer your own woman, right? When you become a part of the kingdom of God, the Bible says that you were what? You were bought with a price, right? So when you seek first the kingdom of God, you understand that God is number one. He's at the top of the list. He's in control. But not only that, that he sets the laws, amen, and he sets the rules, amen. Well, preacher, where do I get that from? From the word of God, right? From the word of God. And I shared with you before, what we do, how we live, how we act and react to life shows us if God's word, if God is number one, and if God is in control of our lives. I share with us all of the time. You, when a person says that, oh, I love Christ, right? He's my savior. Yes, he saves you, but he's got to become your Lord, right? And what does that mean? Your ruler. That means that the things that you do, right, reflect his word. Reflect who he is. Reflect what he did on Calvary's cross. Reflects what the word of God has to say. God sets the rules. God sets the laws. And the Bible says, seek ye first what? The kingdom of God. So you got to understand something, right? Hear me well. there's some people who may be saved, but their priorities are not right. Wait a minute, preacher. How you know that? Well, you show me somebody who's doing something that's opposite of the word of God, and I'll show you that that part of the Bible is not important to them. Amen. Praise the Lord. So you got to get that, right? So what we do, how we act, how we react to things really prove to us what's really important to us. And God's word should be very, very important to us. But not only that, the Bible says this in Romans chapter 12, verses 1 and 2. It says, I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, to present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God, right? And it says, do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, so that you may prove what is that good, watch it now, and acceptable, watch it now, and perfect, watch it, will of God, right? So as a child of God, the will of God should be vital and important to us, right? What God wants. How many of you can say there's some times when you prayed for something, but God said something else? God allowed something else to happen. God went another direction, right? And so God's will has to be important to us. Well, wait a minute, preacher. How is that different from his word? Watch me. This is how it's different from his word. His will is what he wants at that moment. Oh, Jesus. Watch it now. His will is what he desires at that moment. So watch. Check me out. Many of us have prayed for things. Many of us have desired certain things. And so what happens is we've prayed to God for certain things. But guess what? God says, yes, you're within your right to pray for it. It's not a bad thing to pray for what you're praying for. Matter of fact, it may even be in the word of God where I told you to pray for this, but in this instance and in this case, that's not my will. Oh, Jesus, right? And so you got to understand that God's will has to be important to you as well. Where you get that from? Remember Christ? Christ said it. Father, please what? Remove this cup, right? So at the moment, right, Christ really said, get me out of this, right? I'm going to you, Father. I know you can change it. I know you're almighty. I know you can change this. But look what he says. Nevertheless, not my will, but what? Thy will be done. So God's will has to be important to you. Some of you have prayed for a job, amen, that God would come through, right? And ain't nothing wrong for praying for that job. You had people praying for you and all, didn't get the job. You was mad, you were sad, disgusted, and upset. Then time went on, you said, well, Lord, your will. And then God sent something later on to show you either number one, he had something better for you, or number two, what the job you were seeking after wasn't worth seeking. Amen, praise the Lord. So God's will has to be what? Important to you. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. So what gets us in trouble many times is when we seek to be the kings and queens of our own world. Oh my gosh, right? That's what gets us in trouble, when we seek to be kings and queens of our own world, right? And so when we take a look at it, it says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, right? His righteousness. And I'm just going to share a little bit about it, and then I'm going to close us out. Right now, I'll get into his righteousness on next week, right? God's righteousness, right? And his righteousness, his goodness, right? His goodness. What is right in the sight of God? Living an upright life, living in such a way, amen, praise the Lord, to where God is pleased with what you're doing. I'm gonna end with this question. God gave me this question today. I was in the middle of doing something, and God hit me over the head with this question, and it really had me, and I was like, okay, Lord, man, I gotta do a self-evaluation as well. And this is the question God gave me. Do you want to be remembered as being popular, or do you want to be remembered for being a Christian? Do you want to be remembered as popular, or do you want to be remembered as a Christian? Because see, when you seek ye first the kingdom, people will know that you are a believer, because they know that you've lived your life as a believer and as a Christian, right? And so God gave me that question because, you know, I'm going to tell you what we'll do sometimes. We'll say things, but it ain't in the Bible. Oh, you preach your own funeral, right? We'll say stuff like that, right? And we'll talk about people. Yeah, boy, the church was packed. They had so many people. But can I help you? God doesn't want us to be just remembered as popular. God wants us to be remembered as being a Christian. Right? Were you known for standing up for his word? Were you known for seeking his will? Were you known for praying? Were you known for fasting? Were you known for doing what? The will of God. Right? And so God gave me that question, and I just want to submit it to you on tonight. Do you want to be remembered as just popular, or do you want to be remembered as a child of God? Right? And if we set our priorities right, we will be remembered as a child of God. And guess what? It ain't nothing you try to get people to see, right? You ain't got to walk around, amen, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, all day long, no, right? Because I know some folk, amen, praise the Lord, they walk around all day long, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, but they cussing folk out in the parking lot, and they causing mess, and they causing trouble, and they doing all kind of, so I'm not talking about that. I'm just talking about you just living a life, amen, praise the Lord, that just honors God. And guess what? God himself will have to say, well done, thy good and thy faithful servant. And I listen, let me tell you how I can say that. See, I there's some things I've experienced, amen, praise the Lord, and I want to share this with you, right? And the reason why I just said what I just said, because I experienced it, right? And I'm going to say it, and I'm going to go on, and I'm going to leave it alone. There was a time when I went visit one of my preacher friends. Amen. I ain't saying no names. I'm not saying who it is. I'm not saying who involved. I'm going to just tell you about the incident. I was going to visit one of my preacher friends, and I was walking into the church, and somebody stopped me before I walked in. Oh, don't listen to that man. That man is this, and he's that, and he's the other. Nah. Who's the man they were talking about? They were talking about the pastor. But this the same one, amen, praise the Lord, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, you know, and all this other stuff, right? So we've got to understand this one thing, right? We gotta realize that guess what? We can do all that stuff, and we can put on these facades and stuff like that. But can I help you? What's really important to us, right? It's going to show up. It's going to show up in our lives. Right? So if the kingdom of God is important to you, I promise you that guess what? People will notice, you will notice, your children will notice, people around you will notice that guess what? God, his kingdom, his word, his will, right? His power and sovereignty is important to you. I pray that you are blessed on tonight, and I pray that you tune in on next week, if the Lord wills it to be so, as we share what God has for us to share. Amen. Top priority. I want you in 2021, I want you checking your priorities. Amen. Praise the Lord. Checking what's important to you. And guess what? You got to understand, all of our priorities are different. Right? And all of us got to do a check. Even the pastor. Amen. Praise the Lord. What is important? What should be at the top of the list? So in 2021, enter in 2021 asking yourself those questions. And I promise you, that will do you better than a New Year's resolution. You know why? Because you're going to begin to put the right things at the top. And what? Putting those other things that are not quite important at the bottom. Amen. God bless you real good is my prayer. Amen. It was a little different for me on tonight. I'm used to seeing you all's comments and stuff, because I love to see your comments. I love the interaction. amen, between you all, amen. So I can't see your comments on tonight. So I see some of the faces popping up, amen. I think I saw Sister Courtney a couple of times, Sister Clara, I saw you a couple of times, amen, through the emojis. The emojis are showing up, but the words are not showing up, amen. I saw my wife, amen, Sister Chantel. Who else I saw? Sister Norma, I saw. A couple of others I saw. Amen. Amen. I think that's Sister Sandra right there. Amen. And so I saw a couple of you all on tonight. Amen. And so God bless you real good. I think that's Sister Kai. I think that was Sister Kaisha maybe. I don't know. It looked like her. Amen. So God bless you. Sister Pam, I see you. Amen. I see you. I see you. Amen. So God bless you on tonight. I pray you are blessed. Amen. And listen, spend time in the Word. Amen. So you can share the Word. Amen. Let this year be a year that you give God your best. Let this be a year where you just serve God with all your heart, mind, soul, and strength. And just watch God move. Amen. I'm praying that for you on this year. And I'm praying that God blesses you. Amen. In some kind of way. I want to pray for you and with you on tonight. Amen. And I pray for all of you that God will just keep you, protect you, and direct you. Let us pray. Lord, I come to you on tonight just to say thank you. Lord, thank you for using me. And I thank you for your people who are hungry and thirsty for the Word of God. Pray for those who tuned in on tonight and even those who are going to see the live in the nights and days to come. And I pray, Lord, that you would just allow them to be blessed by the Word. And Lord, I pray right now that their lives are blessed so that they begin to look toward you, Father God. Lord, as their strength, their Redeemer, their Savior, their Lord, that they, Lord, know that they need you. Lord, that they know, dear God, that they need you as their Lord and as their Savior. Lord, help us to prioritize and help us to put first things first. And Lord, we give you all the praise. Help us as we go along our way to just do your will and let you handle the rest. We love you, we thank you, and we give you all the praise, honor, and glory. It's in the mighty and wonderful and precious name of Jesus that we do pray. Amen. Amen. God bless you on tonight. Amen. Take care of yourselves. Just remember Sunday, we're going to have our groundbreaking. Amen. Looking at the weather. Amen. Look like it might hold off until that evening, but pray, y'all. I want y'all praying so we can do what we need to do. Won't be long, but it's something we need to do to acknowledge what God has done for us and with us. So I want you all to come out, amen, on Sunday and just, you know, come in fellowship one with the other. Just be in each other's presence and we can celebrate together. Amen. God bless you. Amen. Real good is my prayer. And remember, on Sunday, we'll have church at 1. Amen. And depending on how church goes, weather, whatever, we may just kind of bump up the ceremony just a little bit. Amen. Just to avoid any kind of weather or whatnot. But I'll let us know what we're going to do. And we're going to let God just have his way. Amen. Not our will. Thy will be done. Amen. God bless you. Good night to you all. Love you all. Amen. And I thank you all for your support and your prayers. Pray for your pastor. Amen. Because he needs it. Amen. And I pray for you as well. Good night, y'all.